that few products of modern industry have received the acclaim afforded Rolls-Royce and Bentley motor cars. This astonishing fact evolves not just from a coming together of events, but from the minds and souls of three equally extraordinary, though very different, men. Henry Royce, spending his teenage years as an apprentice in the metal shops of the Great Northern Railway, dominates the infant science of electrical engineering and becomes a most successful businessman. Having purchased a second-hand car, Royce finds himself disenchanted with its inefficient, unreliable performance. Within days, he proclaims his intention to single-handedly design and build a superior two-cylinder motor car. By the spring of 1904, he has succeeded remarkably. Royce's prototype represents an astonishing advance in comfort, smoothness, quietness, and reliability. Word of Royce's achievement quickly reaches one of Britain's best drivers, the Honourable Charles Stuart Rolls. Third son of Baron Langattock, the young aristocrat has converted his love of cars into a spectacular racing career, triumphing in the British 1,000-mile trial of 1900 and setting a world land speed record of 93 miles per hour at Dublin's Phoenix Park. Also a major vehicle distributor, Rolls dreams that someday his name will be to motor cars as Stradivarius is to the violin. Meeting at Manchester, Rolls and Royce agree to collaborate on the creation of a motor car, one that will reflect their passion for innovation, talent for development, and above all, their unshakable insistence upon perfection. The Rolls-Royce Motor Car Company is born. Within 3 years, the Silver Ghost becomes the first of many models to be acclaimed as the world's best car. It is still the dawn of the industry, yet Rolls-Royce has already claimed the preeminence that it will retain for all the years to come. W.O. Bentley was no less a pioneer than Rolls and Royce, but it was the sporting potential of the motor car which most ignited his imagination. Following World War I, during which he designed the first high-performance engines for the Royal Navy Air Service, Bentley turned his newfound knowledge of speed to his greatest passion, the creation of a powerful and very sporting motor car. An astonishing series of triumphs followed. Bentley's legendary 3-litre motor car swept the team prize in the Tourist Trophy race, while his 4.5-litre finished powerfully in the Premier Brooklyn's 24-hour contest. But it was at the Le Mans 24-hour race that the Bentley legend was solidified. From 1927 to the end of 1930, Bentley motor cars finished first 4 times in a row, a record that was to remain unbroken for nearly 40 years. 1931. Two of the most distinguished marks in automotive history are joined. While Rolls-Royce remains renowned for its unmatched quality and elegance, and Bentley for the ultimate in luxury and performance, both represent a standard of motor car building that has never been equaled. There is no greater expression of the quality and uniqueness of the Rolls-Royce and Bentley motor cars than their means of construction. No other car makers use finer materials. No other companies take up to 6 months to hand assemble each motor car. And while advanced technology plays a crucial role, it is finally the individual craftsmen who have enabled the marks to achieve such lasting and universally acknowledged success. Indeed, it has been said that to know these motor cars is to know the people who made them.
I would say that today that we are using the same processes as they were using in the 15th century. It's been passed on through days gone by right up to the present day. The veneer comes from the part that's actually under the ground, hence the burr effect. Because wherever a root comes out, it leaves like a little swirl in the veneer. And so the more roots comes out, the more swirls that you get. It's all cut and matched and selected for each individual car, after which it is all glued on to the individual components that it's going on. It will be machined on router machines, spindle machines. Then it will be cleaned up, all hand cleaned up, and after it will be polished. More expensive, yes, but we are making Rolls-Royces. I feel that we make the best car we've ever made. I feel I've contributed towards that. Well, I hope I have.
The radiator shell is constructed from individual pieces of stainless steel, which are shaped by hand, hand filed to a precise fitting joint. These panels, of course, are soldered together. The shells, of course, go through the polishing process then. The polishers expose the joint line to achieve something which we hope to be no thicker than a human hair. The aim of the game is to achieve that joint line, which is absolutely perfect. There are 8 men in the world building radiator shells. We build our own shell from flat plates and are responsible for the shell until it is finished and fitted onto the car. Myself, of course, I use a double D stamp on the back of the shell that identifies my work. And of course, I use that double D stamp because it's so nice, I stamped it twice.
Each engine is built by hand. It is individually assembled. I would say it was cared for. No engine is the same. They've all got their own little characteristics. They're all adjusted individually. It's like drillings in different positions to bring the engine into balance. We physically examine a part before we fit a part. We make sure there's no burrs and no knocks and that everything's clean and dust-free before we actually assemble. I like to build everything how a Rolls and Royce would want it built. You don't come with Rolls-Royce in your blood when you first come working here, but it's sort of put into you. You see how traditions have been going on over the years, and you want to carry that tradition on. You just don't want to knock anything together. It's part of the English heritage. And to be part of that is something great.
I'm a senior development engineer involved in the development of suspension systems for Rolls-Royce and Bentley motor cars. The people who are involved in the crafts of woodwork, leather, and the makers of the radiator, they have to always look back for their skills and trades. We, on the contrary, have to look at what they're doing, make sure we're not out of step with that, but to adapt that philosophy whilst looking to the future. Well, if we take the suspension system, the variable ride system, which we developed as an example, we needed a system which could detect the road, the driver's behaviour, and the vehicle manoeuvre quickly enough to be able to adapt itself to suit those conditions. And this meant that we had to develop an electronic control system, which in automotive terms was sophisticated. We created our own technology in that case. Working at Rolls-Royce is not a job as such. It's a quest for perfection in automobile engineering. It's a never-ending pursuit of something which seems unattainable today, but you know will be reality tomorrow.
The current line of Rolls-Royce and Bentley motor cars manifests the company's long tradition of the pursuit of excellence, whilst revealing unmistakable advances in luxury, engineering, and performance. The Rolls-Royce, of course, remains the mark of kings, the ultimate luxury motor car. The Silver Spirit II is a superbly comfortable four-door motor car. Like all Rolls-Royce models, it has been engineered to create a driving experience that, even across long distances at high speeds, leaves you completely refreshed. Of course, anti-lock braking has been included into every motor car. The Silver Spur II accommodates driver and passengers with extraordinary levels of comfort. A longer wheelbase complements electronically adjustable rear seats, while the concealed cellular telephone keeps you in constant touch. Moreover, as with all of our four-door motor cars, the Silver Spur II boasts a remarkable electronically controlled suspension system, which instantaneously adapts to changing road surfaces and driving conditions. The pride of the craftsman at Mulliner Park Ward, the Corniche, remains the fullest expression of the values for which the Rolls-Royce motor car stands. One of the last of the truly coach-built motor cars, its hand-assembled body panels describe a shape long acknowledged as classic. The Corniche remains our most elegant testament to the satisfactions of open-top touring. Stamped indelibly by its racing lineage, the Bentley stands unrivaled as one of the world's most impressive driving experiences. Its distinctive mesh grille, reminiscent of the first Bentleys ever to triumph at Le Mans, captures the style and sporting heritage of the Bentley 8. From any viewpoint, the Mulsanne S presents a striking picture of rakish elegance. Chromium-plated vanes and grille arrest the eye. The finest Connolly hides and Wilton carpets soothe the soul. Yet the Mulsanne S remains every inch the consummate driver's motor car. In appearance, appointment, and sheer force of personality, the Bentley Turbo R stands unchallenged. Powered by the aluminium alloy 6.75-litre turbocharged V8 engine, the Turbo R delivers speeds in excess of 135 miles per hour on a test track. The electronically controlled suspension system creates a formidably commanding ride. Moreover, the Turbo R reveals an elegance every bit as bracing as its performance. The gracious pleasures of open-air motoring, the coach builder's art, the satisfactions of luxury, and the thrill of a great touring car all come together seamlessly in the Bentley Continental. The Continental is a powerful representative of the sporting Bentley mark. All the more amazing in a motor car so plush and so stylish. At the dawn of the century, Henry Royce put forth a philosophy of car making which still applies equally to Rolls-Royce and Bentley. Strive for perfection in everything you do. Take the best that exists and make it better. When it does not exist, design it. Accept nothing nearly right or good enough. Words that have stood the test of time.
When you first glimpse the new Rolls-Royce, you will be seeing the latest refinement in technology and elegance for the world's most luxurious motor car. The new sleek appearance has been achieved through the subtlest of changes to the classic grille design, still made by hand and stamped with the craftsman's own insignia. The new proportions, combined with the reshaped air dam, have streamlined the front, while the integrated bumpers and color-coded sills continue the smooth line around the car to the rear. By adding new and larger 16-inch road wheels with specially designed lower profile tires, there is a noticeable improvement in road holding, responsiveness, handling, and above all, comfort. Moreover, the new wheels contribute appreciably to the new profile. In the quest for higher standards of luxury and comfort for driver and passengers alike, the new interior presents some thoughtful innovations. An adjustable tilt steering wheel column, linked to the seat position memory, swings up to allow easy entry and exit when the door is opened or when the key is removed from the ignition. The redesigned center armrest now houses the CD multi-changer, as well as the telephone, for convenience and accessibility. The new center console sweeps up to the restyled fascia, with veneered panels revealing the cigar lighter and the new in-car entertainment controls, which have been regrouped for simple operation.